Hi everyone, this is Joel Breakstone from the Stanford History Education Group. I'm briefly going to demonstrate how I might go about evaluating this website using the CRAAP test. Based on the CRAAP test, I might conclude that this website is in fact reliable. The CRAAP test asks about currency and whether or not links work. The link here works. It tells me, it takes me to the report from the Government Accountability Office. The CRAAP test also asks about the date on the webpage. And if I scroll down, I can see that there is a 2020 copyright here. The CRAAP test also asks about the relevance of the information. If I'm hoping to learn about energy development regulation, the information here seems to be quite relevant to that topic. There is a list of federal laws, a host of organizations that engage in regulation. So there's information that is relevant to that issue. The CRAAP test also asks about the authority of the source. It's not entirely clear who's making this website. It says that it's from the Center for Organizational Research and Education. I don't know who that is. It sounds kind of credible. But the CRAAP test also tells me that I should consider whether or not there is contact information. There is contact information down here at the bottom of the page again. And it also asks about the top-level domain. It is a .org website. And in some cases, CRAAP tests indicate that that might make a source more credible. That is not the case, but that's what some CRAAP tests suggest. There's also the question of accuracy. Where does the information come from? Has it been reviewed? So at least in one case, as I noted before, there's a link to a Government Accountability Office report, which would be a credible source in many cases. As well, the CRAAP test asks about typos, and a quick scan of this document does not reveal any immediate typos here either. Similarly, the CRAAP test asks about whether or not I can verify any of the information from personal knowledge. And just doing a quick look through this, I see that there are a lot of references to federal laws related to environmental regulation, which I'm familiar with. So that all seems accurate. There is finally the question of purpose. The CRAAP test asks us to consider who is the sponsor of the website and the purpose of the information. But it never tells us how to go about doing that. And the name listed here, Center for Organizational Research and Education, on its face appears like it, or at least sounds like it, might be trustworthy. I need to read laterally in order to find out more information. The CRAAP test could really lead me astray.